Number 5. Wax moth. When the cold winter is over and the weather starts to get a bit warmer, the wax moth already waits for the opportunity to occupy the small, weak or even dead bee colonies. The wax moth finds a hole, gets into the hive and starts tunneling under the cell caps and eating the wax and the brood, leaving behind an extremely sticky white web. Because they are tunneling between the combs, it's hard for the bees to locate them. As they tunnel, they also lay eggs. If the bees notice the intruder and the eggs, they try to kill it and carry the eggs outside the hive. If not, the whole hive will be destroyed. However, the wax moth is not always a bad guy. Sometimes unoccupied or weak, beehives can contain harmful pathogens that could cause damage to insects. By eating the combs, the moths can reduce the harm to insects of that region and provide a clean space for other organisms to inhabit. Now we have mixed feelings about these insects.
Number 4. Birds. Most of the birds are omnivorous, and most of them stick to slow-moving insects. But these colorful bee eaters will catch a bee in a flight. They can spot a bee even from a distance up to 100 meters. When the poor bee is caught, the bee eater returns to the perch, where they smack the bee on the branch and rub her to discharge the venom sac and stinger. When the bee contains no more venom, the bird eats it. The juvenile bee eaters, when eating bees for the first time, will eat the bee with the stinger. But after a couple of times, they will learn on their mistakes and know what to do. Woodpeckers use another method. They peck a hole in the hive and eat the bees through it.
Number 3. Spiders. Webs are everywhere. If a bee gets caught, it will be pretty hard for her to escape the web. Although the bee has been caught, this is far from an easy catch for the spider. They will bite the bee with their jaws, wrap it in silk, but the whole time they have to be careful not to get stung by the bee. The wrapped, hurt bee is then left to die. After a couple of hours or days, the spider comes and vomits the digestive fluid over the bee. Then the bee is chewed with the jaws and the fluid is sucked back into the mouth, together with some liquefied meat from the bee. But some spiders do not use the web to catch a bee. Here we have a jumping spider. It can leap 50 times its body length and land right on the honeybee while she's sitting on a flower.
Number 2. Varroa, the destructor. Those parasites destroy thousands and thousands of bee families each year. It all starts with attaching to a bee in the nature. As the bee is flying to her hive, the Varroa mite already feeds on her blood. When the infected bee gets into the hive, the Varroa mite detaches itself from the bee and crawls into the comb where the brood is. Then it climbs on top of that cocoon and starts to feed on its blood and lay a couple of eggs. They repeat this process over and over again and can grow their population up to the same number as the hive population. But when the winter comes and the bee population declines, the hive is left with a huge mite population, which is dangerous for the hive.
Number 1. Pesticides. Depending on the type of the pesticide and toxicity, some of them can even kill the bees instantly. Systemic pesticides are usually applied into the soil or onto seeds, which are then incorporated into plant parts such as nectar. The contact pesticides are usually sprayed on plants and can have an instant effect on the bee health. Some of the nowadays used pesticides influence the bee's coordination and memory, and can make her more susceptible to infections. One of those that have been more researched are neonicotinoids. Neonicotinoids are currently the most widely used class of insecticides worldwide. A research group from Switzerland did a worldwide survey of neonicotinoids in honey and analyzed 198 honey samples from across the world. 75% of tested samples contained at least 1-5 nicotinoid compounds,